Hello everyone, it's Shane Kanto, your Wasteland reviewer, and here's a review of a film that I absolutely loved and actually is sitting at my number one film of 2019 so far, and that's Arctic. And I was super excited when I saw this trailer and all the great reviews it was getting, because I'm a huge fan of Mads Mikkelsen, and kind of funny thinking about he's in a film called Polar on Netflix, and then Arctic in the theaters, and if I had to pick one, duh. Go see Arctic. And there's been a long tradition of survival films, and some of the big ones more recently, thinking about The Gray, which is not Taken with Wolves, or The Revenant. And this film, I feel like, really does a fantastic job of not falling into a lot of the cliches and repetitiveness about survival films, and not going to the point where one of my biggest issues with The Revenant was I felt like so many things happened to this man that after a while this movie was just mean-spirited and just trying to purposely push you to see how many different things this movie can throw at this character and how much the audience can take. This film, I feel, felt like it was much more natural kind of progression, and felt like this film, directed by and written by Joe Pena, is a great film, and it builds a natural momentum throughout the film of where this film is going. It doesn't overstay its welcome at any point, and it doesn't feel like they're just needless things thrown out. Everything feels natural, and I never sat and thought, oh my god, another thing is happening, or feeling repetitive. And there's some amazing camera work in this film that builds some fantastic tension that I guess I wasn't fully expecting, but I guess I should have been, because I've heard really great things about this film, and this film really works in terms of great editing, putting shots together, and building a great amount of tension throughout this film, because there's two actors in this whole entire film. Maria Thelma's Samara Dotir, I probably butchered that, and then Mads Mikkelsen, and unfortunately, Maria Thelma Sema Dotir doesn't get a whole lot to do. She's kind of unconscious and in pain and hurting throughout most of this film, but Mads Mikkelsen carries this film on his back with a lot of natural physicality and emotion, and you really feel it and feel the desperation in him. And some of the things in this film that were highly unexpected, I knew there was like a polar bear sequence from the trailer. They didn't use any CGI, and they used a real polar bear. And it made it feel grittier and realer and tenser, because one of my biggest things about The Gray is, how am I supposed to be freaked out about a bunch of obnoxiously CGI wolves that don't even look real? This was real, and it was freaky. And there's some really tense moments and really great cinematography and gorgeous to look at film. It's anchored by this amazing performance by Mads Mikkelsen. Definitely a big favorite right now for me for lead actor. Obviously, there's so much more of the year to go through, but right now, he seems like I would nominate him for this performance, and I would nominate Arctic as a great film. And not gonna lie, there hasn't been a film that I like full-heartedly loved yet at this point in the year. And going back to last year, I had a couple at this point, because Paddington 2 came out and I was just gushing about that movie, how much I loved it. And then Annihilation had come out at this point, and nothing beat Annihilation for me. Do I feel like Arctic's gonna be one of those films that are really gonna hold it for me? This doesn't feel as strong as a hold as Annihilation was, but because the one thing that I didn't appreciate about this film is it falls into that cliche of, it's more of a silent film. There's not a lot of talking in it because there's not a whole lot of characters to engage with, but then still having exposition spouted out in dialogue talking to yourself, and it feels super unnatural, and it wasn't even like in a clever, like, I'm trying to think of a great example of dialogue of an isolated character is, say, Die Hard, where he's like, come out to LA, have a good time, we'll have some laughs. Like, him talking to himself in that film feels so natural because he just feels like a really frustrated every guy, and Bruce Willis is so charismatic and makes it work. So many films where it's just like, I'm gonna spout exposition to myself because why the hell not? And there's moments like that that frustrated me a little bit in this film, because the more frustrating thing is there's like ways of showing that on screen while he was saying it. I'm like, you didn't have to say anything. But the thing is, most mainstream audiences aren't gonna sit through almost a completely silent film and need to have some dialogue in there, because there was some dialogue and him trying to interact with the young woman in this film, and that felt super endearing and had a nice connection in this film. And you can really feel that connection of him really trying to get them out of the situation, being trapped up in the Arctic after a plane crash. And it's a beautiful film, it's a powerful film, it's a tense film, it's a fantastic performance from Mads Mikkelsen. Highly recommend this film. I had to drive down to Voorhees, like a 45-minute drive, because it was the only theater within like an hour radius of me that was showing it. But it was worth the drive. I'm so glad I got to see this. And go check out Arctic when it comes to you. And let me know what you think. And thank you, as always, for supporting your Wasteland reviewer.